Hello friends, welcome back. My name is Priyendra Kumar and in this video you will learn how we can create a beautiful weekly sales report chart. So as you are seeing my screen, I have this table. In this table I have employee name here, and for particular employee I have weekly data. This is the day, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday and Friday, and this is the total of the week. And here in this graph I have display the total for each employee, and here I have also displayed in small bars the day on day trend of that particular employee. Okay friends, so we will learn today how we can create these both of the chart in a single chart. Okay, so I'll copy this and we'll go to the new worksheet. I'll click on this plus button and I will paste this data here. So we will create the chart on this data. Okay, to creating this chart I need a support column. Here I'm going to create a column which is bottom line, and bottom line I'll take 0 and just fill it down. Sorry. Okay, now I'll select this data, the entire data, and I will go to the insert and I'll go to the charts. Then I will go to the column chart and will take this one which is clustered column. Click on this. So this is the column chart has been created. It will look like this. Now right click here and go to the select data. Here in select data you can see this switch row column option is available. Just click on this. Now click on OK. Now our chart has been changed and it will look like this. Now click on this total. This is the total bar you can see here. So click on this total bar column and right click and go to the chain series chart type. Here in chain series chart type you can see the total and bottom line option and rest the day's name. So all the chart is currently clustered column, you can see here. Now I'll change the chart type for total and for bottom line. And for total I'll take this chart type which is line. You can take it from here, click on this. And for bottom line I'll take chart type again the same chart type line and click on OK. All right, so our total chart has been changed into line and the bottom line also in line. So first of all I will select this total line, then I'll click on this plus button. Here you can see this option available which is up down bars. Click on this. Okay, and then I'll go to the format data series. So you can right click and go to the format data series, and this window is already opened. So click here and click on plus button. Here you can see this option available which is gap width. Change the gap width and take it approximately 30. Make sure this all the chart for particular employee should go behind this bar, up bar, oh sorry, down bar. Okay, like this. You can take it 30 is good. All right, now I'll go to this fill and line option. Here in this fill and line option I'll choose no line for this total line. Choose it no line. All right, now I'll select this blue line for the bottom line. Select this blue line, click here, and then I'll go to the format data series again, and here in fill and line option just take it as no line for this blue line also. All right, now friends I'll click on this bar, down bar, and I'll fill a gradient color in this. So I'll go to the gradient fill, and then this is some gradient fill which is default available here. So I'll remove the second stop. We need only two stop to fill the gradient fill, and I'll fill the first color as, so I'm taking this violet theme or the purple theme. So you can click on this purple color. If you want to take any other color, you can take it. And for the second, I'll take it as white. But for this white, I'll take 100% transparency. So just make sure here should be 100% transparency. Okay, and we also need to remove the borders from this bar. Okay, so click on this and go to the fill and line option again. Just go to the border. Here in border, you can see this no line option is available. Click on this. Okay, friends, now, so we will add data label. Our chart is almost ready, and we will create our chart like this. We'll add data label and this grid lines in the chart. So first of all, I'll remove this total and bottom line from the legend. So just select this total only and press delete button in your keyboard. So it has been removed. Now click on this bottom line, click twice here, and then just press delete button. Okay, now it is Monday to Friday. So now click on this. To add the data label, we have to select the line which we have already given a no line. So we won't be able to select from here. So what I will do, I'll go to the format, and here you can see this option available, which is it is currently showing downbar 2 because I have selected downbar. Now click on this drop down. Here you can see this series total. Okay, so this was the total line, so it has been selected. You can see the right click here and then add data label. You can see data label has been added. Now click on the data label, right click and go to the format data label. And in the format data label, you can see this label position available. Just click on above. So data labels are properly visible now. Just make data label bold and color black. And now we will give the shape of data label like this. So here right click and then go to the change data label shapes and take any shapes. I have taken this one. Okay, now we will fill the color in the shapes like we have filled here. So what I have done, I'll go to the design, sorry, format, then I have taken any format from here like this, then I have filled the purple color, the theme color of the chart. Okay, friends, now we will make it bold and font size, font color black, bold and black, bold and black. Similarly for the chart title, and here you can give some chart title like weekly report or any other. Okay, now to create the grid lines like this, here I have created, I'll select the chart, then I'll click on this plus button, then I'll go to the grid lines and click on this arrow, and I'll check all the grid lines. You can see the major horizontal, major vertical, and similarly minor horizontal and minor vertical. Now I'll select this line, okay, the vertical lines, okay, and then I'll go to the format, and here I'll take shape outline color as black. So it will bifurcate all the employee in the different section. All right, friend. So now our chart is absolutely ready. And friends, this chart can be useful in your weekly sales or any other weekly data or any other data wherein you want to showcase the total along with their bifurcation. So here you can see I have showcased the total bars, and here you can see the small what it can be said, this line chart, no sorry, the column chart. Okay, friends, I hope you have enjoyed this video. Thank you so much for the watching.